Thank you for having me here. And thank you, audience, for being so patient. It's been 4 hours, nearly. Now, before I start with what you're seeing here, I'll ask two questions. If you can answer, fine. Otherwise, I'll answer them for you. One, which is the most important part of your body? The brain wins here, but usually it's 50-50. Now, why do we say the heart and not the brain? And why do we say the brain and not the heart? Mostly it is because we believe that the heart feels and the brain thinks. Actually, both feeling and thinking is done by the brain, not by the heart. Heart is only a rubber organ which pumps blood. Now, it's nothing else. The feeling also is from here. But the brain is what we are talking about. The teaching technique for the 21st century, we call it creative education. You've heard this word, creativity, spoken by almost every speaker. But you know what it means. Actually, creativity means good ideas and imagination. If imagination can be used to create good ideas, to replace ordinary ones, or better ideas to replace good ones, then you become creative. But this does not happen to us every moment. And this technique teaches you to be creative with every breath of your life. That is all there is to it. If you become creative, you'll be richer, you'll be happier, you'll be healthier, you'll also be at peace with yourself, and you'll have great relationships. And we started at school because we have 300 million students in India and 1,700 million students in the world. That's 25% of the world's population. And once you capture this 25% population, it trains the other remaining three-fourths. A child goes and trains his parents, changes their mindsets, changes his brother's, sister's mindsets. This is what we are trying to do. And how we do it. Now, there is also 21st century. 21st century is very impatient. It wants change quickly. Everybody wants to become rich very quickly. Everybody wants happiness at the doorstep. Everybody wants information at the touch of a button. Now, those who are sitting here and those they represent is 1% of society. These are in the archway. They will get. They will always succeed. But what about the remaining 99% who live in villages, who do unorganized labor, a rickshaw puller, or a carpenter, or a mason, who are not within the scheme of things? This is essentially for them, though it is also for you. Now, the first word is what we make a mistake, and that's why we have been doing what we have been doing for thousands of years. Education is derived from the Latin word educare. Some call it educe, some call it educo, Latin, Greek. Now, educare means to draw out ideas, information from children. We have been pumping in information for thousands of years. A teacher comes, pumps in what he or she has learned from a book, mugged up, and once he or she completes the entire course, he says the syllabus is over. He has no way of interacting. Okay, this is one of the most important things which actually inspired us. Education is the only weapon which can change the world. Now, weapon is a bad word, but that's what he used. And if we can use it as a weapon with the precision of a missile, then we can change the world. And we believe that there is no other thing, no amount of talking, no amount of lectures that you hear, which will change the world other than your own mind. And we also believe that we exercise all our muscles. We go to a gym. We do yoga sessions. We go for walking, brisk walks, running, swimming. But our brain is also a muscle. It needs to be exercised. If we use our hands mechanically, we'll go weak. We have been using our brains mechanically for hundreds and thousands of years. And that's why our brain has grown weak. The lady here spoke about education is the manifestation of perfection already in man. We are already born perfect. Education must bring out that perfection. When it brings it out, only then will education hold its true purpose. The teaching technique of creative educators. The first thing is, what do we do differently than what others are doing? What the schools and colleges have been doing? The first we do is, under conventional teaching, a teacher addresses the whole class. There's a lecture method of teaching, lecturing. And those who are married, the girls, do not want to be lectured even by their own husband for 10 minutes. And the husbands definitely don't want it for 5 minutes. Now, if we can't get lectured by our own Ardhangani or our own better half or our own Pati Parmeshwar for 5 minutes, we are lecturing for 8 hours helpless children. For 300 days, 15 years, lakhs and lakhs of hours. And the children can't fight back. So they become chaotic or they go silent. When they go chaotic, we say he's a naughty boy. When he goes silent, we say he has a learning disability. Now what do? We divide students into groups of six. Now six is ideal. It could be reduced to four or up to eight. You can't go to three or you can't go to nine. There have been experiments where groups of 10 were made and they failed. So six is ideal. We have made it from 4 to 8 because if there's a large class of 120, then we may need groups of 8. And if there's a small class of 20, we may need groups of 4. But 6 is ideal. The second is dividing the subject matter within those those in the groups. So a subject matter is there. Let's say there's for class 9 civics, 66 pages, and there are 11 groups. We can give 6 pages to each group. Group 1, 1 to 6, group 2, 7 to 12, and so on till the last one gets 61 to 66. So the equal number of pages are distributed. Here a lady is distributing in a college. Each group reads the portion allotted to it. The teacher does not teach. Each group reads on its own. Now this silent reading is when a child gets familiar with alphabets, then with words, then the ideas that the words convey, and then the concepts. Without that, just hearing is only 11% of our faculty. This is 86%. And it's 4 times better to read than to hear. We say children don't learn English in Hindi medium schools because they don't get familiar with words, with alphabets, with the ideas that they carry. So each group reads the portion allotted to it. Now here we see that 40% are understood by a child. India is a great democratic nation. India as a nation doesn't have to be taught. Great and democracy has to be taught. You learn democracy. Somebody says it's by the people, for the people, to the people. What do we understand? We understand nothing. But when the child, when the teacher tells a child his duties, responsibilities, and above all, power in democracy, then democracy goes forward. And when he tells a child how he can become great himself or how nations can become great, that's how individuals and nations become great. That is where the facilitation in the process of learning comes in, instead of just lecturing. And for this, the teachers will have to elevate their own selves and answer at the level of the child. Answer his curiosity, answer till he's fulfilled. Then each group then discusses the topic. Now this is the most important part. Those who have read Napoleon Hill will know about the Mastermind Club. We call it group dynamics, I'll explain it to you later. Discussion is the most important part of our lives. If you add a discussion, you will also add to the quality and the quantity of your life. Teacher clarifies here also, children resolve among themselves, the students. 70% is resolved. The 30% that is not resolved within the groups, the teacher comes and solves it for them. Now here, even the one who has the least marks has much to say, much to add. And this is what we call as peer learning or peer tutoring. It's a very famous word in the world. So peer learning is a very, very important part of learning. Each group then in turn presents its portion to the whole class. Now this third is what takes care of the first two. Now the moment you know that you have to present it to the rest of the class, you start concentrating. And we have seen that concentration increases from 2%, which is an average in schools, to 40% through this. So the moment concentration increases, the first step, great giant step towards learning, proper education begins. But here, second thing also happens that here you have elocution skills, you have communication skills, your presentation skills, your stage fear goes. And those who are in management will tell you that our management students are unemployable due to two reasons. Lack of communication skills and lack of analyzing skills. And both come here. So communication is very important. Elocution is very important. Speaking English teaches you how to speak. You learn your mother tongue by speaking. But if you don't speak English, you will not learn it. In England, everybody learns English because it's their mother tongue. They don't speak Marathi. All students in the class ask questions. Now the Q&A part comes in. This actually is for the analyzing part. Going into the depth, going into the beyond, because students don't ask ordinary questions. I can tell you 3-4 questions which students asked in some vague village somewhere. One asked, is democracy taking us forward or bringing us back? And a child answered that physically is taking us forward, morally is taking us back, because corruption and democracy can't go hand in hand. Now, one child's question raises the intellectual level of at least 100 other people. This is what is important. Now, I'll speak about group dynamics. I spoke about discussion. We all know about discussion. But even alcoholics discuss. Narendra Modi, good chap. Narendra Modi, terrible man. I don't know what he is. It's taking them nowhere. Women discuss in kitty parties. Oh, what a nice sari. You wore it 3 days back also? Did your husband get it for you? Who else can get it for her? Either she can get it herself or her husband. But we keep on talking, it takes us nowhere. But when we have a common and purposeful cause, we have a common and purposeful direction, and a common and purposeful destination, then it creates a dynamism. There's an explosion of energy. This explosion of energy is actually hundreds and thousands times bigger than the 6 minds that are put together. This is where the power of the mind comes in. We all know that some people tell us that we use only 5% of our minds. Actually, coming to think of it, we don't know, because we haven't used our mind in the way it is meant to be. So perhaps we are using 0.1, because the mind multiplies on itself. The more ideas they come, the more the mind multiplies. So when 6 people come together, this is how Henry Ford became the first millionaire on earth. This is how Apple Computer was formed. Henry Ford had gone bankrupt, and his doctor said, you will die, till he met Thomas Edison. And he met Burbank and Wozniak. And the first Ford Foundation was formed. And he became the first millionaire on earth, and he lived 20 years more. Same was with Steve Jobs. He was a hippie, till he met Wozniak and others. And these 6 created Apple Computer. And every successful person, Raj Kapoor, had a team behind him. A Shailendra and a Shankar Jaikishan and a cinematographer and a story writer and so many others. If he didn't have them, he wouldn't be the Raj Kapoor we know today. So when you want to succeed, make a group of 5 or 6 of like-minded people, of people who can deliver you with ideas, and your education will begin. Now, the Prime Minister Narendra Modi spoke about skill, scale and speed. He's talking about skill development. I brought it here specially because just having skills also is not are also not enough. Like just having education is not enough. The difference between a cook and a chef is not skill. It's creativity. It's intelligence. A cook gets 5,000 rupees and a chef gets another 2 zeros in his salary or 3 zeros. The difference between a tailor and a fashion designer is equally the same. I always say that I'll tell you about education first. If I have 200, I've learned, mugged up 200 books on cooking, I can pass any exam, but can I make a chapati out of it? If I can't, then I don't have skill. But what about if I have to make nutritious meal? The lady of the house has asthma, the husband of the house has diabetes, the grandfather has BP problem, the child has lactose intolerance, and she has to make one meal. That's when intelligence comes in. That's when creativity comes in. So you need both. And then the scale and the speed improves. If you don't have those two, it will not happen. Now, some greats, what they spoke about, and why we are ignoring them. Socrates wanted discussion, it's the same as group dynamics. And we don't have discussion in schools or in colleges. Aristotle wanted freedom through education. But our children are not free. 70% of the villages are not free. 20%, 22% of the unorganized sector is not free. A rickshaw puller is not free. A carpenter or a painter or a mason, a person who tightens nut bolts in a factory is not free. He can barely earn enough. Bernard Shaw wanted child in pursuit of knowledge, not knowledge in pursuit of child. Today we are pursuing. Read this. Tote ki tarah rato. We are making parrots, rote learning. We knowledge is in pursuit of the child, and he's horrified, he's harried, like the gentleman there who failed in his engineering exam. They were pursuing him, and he was scared to death. And then a Eureka moment, like what Sanjay said, came. But that Eureka moment comes in one in a million, or one in 10 million. We want all the 10 million to be great, not one like him. And that's where this technique comes in. Bertrand Russell wanted educators to create intelligence. Now, what is intelligence? We will take the next. What intelligence means? There is a misconception that knowledge is power, or information is power. We believe that this is the world of information technology. Actually, knowledge is not power. Neither is information power. There are 130 million books on Earth. We read only 100. The information is even far greater. How much can you acquire? And if you don't acquire that proverbial drop from an ocean properly, you're doomed. The 100 books, if you choose wrongly, or somebody else chooses for you, out of the 130 million, you're doomed from the very beginning. Life is all about what you want and how you can get what you want. So what you want decides what information you want. That's choosing information. And how you can use it. So the choice and use of information is intelligence or wisdom. This information may not be in school, because school we only acquire 3% of information. The remaining 97% is acquired from nature, from things around us. But this 3% must teach you to select this 97% and select it properly and wisely. Now, what you can do? First of all, you can all join the revolution. That's why I have come to you. It's very easy to implement. It just takes 2 minutes. Hundreds have done it. You can also do it. We had a faculty last year who were class 8, and they went to colleges and did it. And we have already done 5 million students have been demonstrated, trained through this technique. This year it will be 50 million. And in the next 10 years, all the 1,700 million students of the world will be demonstrated through this. Demonstrate the technique in a school or college. At least start a discussion if you can't do that. And create a wave. Instead of talking about Narendra Modi or about the weather, start talking about a new technique you heard. That's very important. If you want to change this world, because I can't see any other thing bringing about a massive change in this world apart from bringing wisdom and intelligence and creativity into education. Nothing else can happen. First of all, human beings are not meant to fail. We are already perfect. They fail due to mechanical use of the minds. We're using our minds. It's a very mechanical use of minds. A teacher comes and teaches you. In the last 15 days, you mug up test series. The best tota goes to an IIT. The next one goes to an IIM. So if our parents and our elders and our teachers are making us parrots, then they will get parrots. And we'll keep on eating chilies. This is what I'm trying to say. And my number is here. Anybody who wants to reach me, you can please take down my number and call me at any time. And then I'll answer your questions, or we can take you within our this thing, system. Thank you very much.